नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, मैं सब सुमित भटनागर अगेन प्रेजेंट बिफोर यू एंड इन दिस केस इट इज सब्सिक्वेंट टू आवर अर्लियर वीडियो दैट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल ट्रेनिंग टू दोज पीपल व्हिच आर नॉट हैविंग एनी फाइनेंशियल बैकग्राउंड. सो एज वी हैव सीन दैट ए मैनेजर ही रिक्वायर्स different records, and in this case the one of the record which is important, that is the cost record provides cost data to managers. And in this case we have already seen that the cost is divided into two parts. On the first is it is classified on the basis of behavior of the cost, and the second is on the element of the cost. Now behavior is divided into fixed cost and the variable cost. Now in fixed cost they are created normally. I will just give you the example to understand this. What are the points in fixed cost? They are created by contractual obligation and managerial decisions. In this case, the rent of the premises, taxes and insurance, staff salaries are example of the fixed cost. Now in variable cost, they are those costs which changes according to the output. In this case, the direct material, direct labor, direct expenses and variable overheads and variable costs are taken. Now, on the basis of this, we have divided the cost now into direct material. Now, what are the direct material cost? Now, it is the cost of basic raw material used for manufacturing a product, and it becomes a part of the product. No finished product can be manufactured without basic raw material. For example, in case of yarn, it is the fiber. For example, in leather wear, it is leather. For example, in paper, it is the pulp. In steel furniture, it is the steel. So, the raw material is the basic thing in this case. Now, then comes the direct labor. The direct labor, it is the amount of wages paid to those workers who are engaged on the manufacturing line for conversion of raw material into finished goods. So, direct expenses or chargeable expenses, in this case, the hired charges for a particular machine used for manufacturing a product, surveyor fees or job cost, excise duty, royalty of production, cost of rectifying defective work, license fees for a product, the utility of such expenses is exhausted on completion of that particular job. Now, what are indirect costs? It consists of indirect material, indirect labor, and indirect expenses. Now, what are the indirect costs? Let's say labor, indirect material. In this case, the lubricants, the grease, oil, stationery, etc., they come under this particular case. While in indirect labor, it is the expenses for the administration, proper watch and ward department, sales department. Now, in the indirect expenses, it includes factory expenses, administrative expenses, selling and distribution expenses. Now, overhead expenses, aggregate of indirect cost is referred to overhead. So in this case we want to know that factory overhead. Now in this factory overhead, it comes a factory salary, works manager salary, factory repairs, rent of factory premises, factory lighting, lubricants, factory power, drying of a salary, cost of internal transport, depreciation of plant and machinery, unproductive wages, etc. current administration expenses. It comes the staff printing and stationery, postage and telegram, telephone charges, rent of office premises, office conveyance, etc. Now, selling and distribution, in this case, the cost of advertisement, showroom expenses, traveling expenses, commission to agents, bad debts written off, commission on sales, rent of sales room, samples of free gifts, free repairs, fancy packing and demonstration, packing charges, loading charges, etc. Now, in the non-cost item, basically goodwill written off, preliminary expenses written off, brokerage, pure financial expenses or losses and expenses not related to the business wealth. So, here you will find the different expenses we are taken into consideration. Now, our main is how to find the cost. Now, in this case, determination of cost can be explained in a very simple figure. In this case, all the direct material, direct labor and direct expenses, they are named as prime cost. Prime cost plus factory overhead. It will give you the factory cost. Factory cost plus office overhead, it will give you the cost of production. And cost of production plus selling and distribution overhead, this will be the total cost. Then total cost plus profit, it will be the selling price. So friends, I hope that the prime cost is known to you. The prime cost is, it comprises of all direct material, direct labor and direct expenses. It is also named as flat cost. The works cost is also called the cost of manufacture. And in this case, the cost of manufacture, what are the points? It is the prime cost plus factory overhead. So, how the division is made of the cost is shown here. I hope that with this video, you must be feeling empowered with the confidence so that you move with a victory. Thank you, friends. Have a nice day.